Hey, we're Trivium.
And you're getting your fix of metal injection.
Rob here with Matt and Paolo of Trivium. My anxiety's clotting. You guys were like one of the first bands that we've actually ever interviewed. And it was like a cool time because you guys were just coming up with like your first Roadrunner album. And like in the 10 years, like I feel like a lot of the bands that were coming up with you guys, they're not really around anymore. So like what have you guys been doing to keep that longevity going, to be around 10 years later, going just as strong as ever?
I think for us, not staying in one place, not being stagnant ever, and always trying to push the boundaries with our music, live shows, everything. And you know, sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't, but I think it's kept us fresh and relevant and just always, I mean, especially with touring, like always going out and, you know, not only just headlining, but supporting, going out with different bands that are, you know, in the same genre, but maybe a little bit different. That's kind of helped keep us in front of a new audience.
And we've always done exactly what we wanted to do as music fans, whether that's making the kind of music we want to hear. Like with Vengeance Falls, we didn't think, are people going to like this? Are people not going to like this? It was just, let's make the music we want to hear. Or if that's doing something like we did within Waves and basically completely restructure the way a metal band can look like, you know, whether the video's having no performance, the live DVD with it having no crowd, there being no color really, it's all black, white, and gray. Little things like that, how we've always just done what we wanted to do when we wanted to do it.
So let's talk about this album, Vengeance Falls, comes out October 15th on Roadrunner. I love the artwork for it. Who did you guys, it looks like a video game art, like who did you guys get to do that?
Brent White. And basically what we did with Brent was we passed him all the demos, all the lyrics, and the basic inspiration where we were going with the record. And that's what he came up with. That was his metaphorical representation of everything he saw as the record itself. So that was his visual interpretation of Vengeance Falling.
Oh, I see. Yeah, it's like...
He's actually done like... ton of shirts for us. I'm not
all our best merch.
Yeah, like he's done some of our best shirts, and after in Waves we just kind of decided like we wanted to have someone actually, you know, draw paint by hand again like we used to do, but wanted to go with someone just different. And when we started looking at all our shirts, we're like, well, our best shirts are by Brent White, so let's see how we'll do an album cover for us. And when he gave it back to us, it was like I had no idea it was going to be like a sci-fi. Yeah,
we didn't know he was going that direction. It was awesome. Yeah, it's been great because the music inspired the art, and then the art inspired our web guys to create the transmission, and then the music video has been inspired from that. So it's constantly different medium of art influencing a different medium of art.
That's really cool. And you guys decided to work with David Draymond of Disturbed. Some might call that a controversial choice. I mean, I'm sure you guys are friends with him and you're like, oh, this guy knows what he's doing. He's a successful musician. Maybe some of that will rub off on us. Is that why you guys, well, why did you guys decide to work with him?
Like you said, if he's a controversial choice, we've always been a controversial band ourselves. So we go hand in hand together. But aside from that, in 2005 was when we first met him in Chicago at a Danzig show. He said, hey, I'm a fan of you guys. You guys are awesome. And we were all blown away because we're all big Disturbed fans. And once a year, we'd meet each other at a random music festival leading all the way up to 2011 when we did Mayhem together. We gave him a copy of In Waves. He loved the record and said that he felt we should work together. So soon he started teaching us how he had a huge part of the production with Disturbed, showed us Device, and right when we heard Device, we knew this man is a producer. Because the same production ingredients, not musical styles or anything like that, but the same production ingredients we loved in Disturbed were also prevalent in Device. So we knew that he was a factor in that. And we worked with him. Not only was he the most hands-on producer we've ever worked with, one of the best vocal coaches I've ever had, but the five of us had such a great chemistry. If we weren't being productive and working our asses off, we're all laughing about something or eating something awesome or hanging out.
Did he try to push some vocal scatting on you, a little wah in the trivia?
In the video.
During the documentary. Yeah. I didn't do it.
Never in the actual music.
I don't think my screaming can do that, but I should have done it.
Recently you made some comments in Metal Hammer about like there needs to be like a metal brotherhood and kids need to come out here listening to like Maiden and Metallica and starting their own bands. How have people reacted to those comments? Because I've seen on one end people being like, yeah, he's right, we need to stick together. And the other end, it's like, oh, who the fuck is this pussy to talk?
Yeah, I mean, that's unfortunate. It's that whole attitude that is killing music. That's why all these turnouts for all these tours around the States are bad right now. Every single tour has bad turnouts. Every single tour has bad pre-sales because this weird elitism. I mean, music's supposed to be the escape for people. It's supposed to be where people can turn to when they're sick of everyday life. For some people, for me, that's what it was. That's why I flocked to metal, because it was an escape from normalcy, or an escape from something I didn't want to be around. And that way I can be enveloped in something great and something where there are other people that shared a common interest. But nowadays, it's weird, because, you know, even like you just mentioned, like whenever people talk about our band, they kind of bring up the negative stuff. It's like, well, why isn't it about the positivity? Why isn't it about the fact that we all get to bond through this amazing style of music and find all these new bands through other great bands? And if it was more supportive, I think more bands would be able to exist. You could see bands keep disbanding. Like the first question you mentioned, a lot of bands that we start off with are gone because they're not able to financially stick around, because people aren't supporting music. They're not going to the shows. They're not really buying the records. Everyone's ripping on everything all the time. Not everyone, but a small, very vocal minority. I found the strike won't make the bleeding stop, nor will it take away the pain. I feel like this search is all in vain, and I struggle to find my way.
We asked some of your fans on Twitter earlier today if they had any questions for you guys. I just wanted to read some of them, because a few of them were not so good, but some of them were pretty good. A lot of people are asking, like, are there any countries that you're going to be touring on that you haven't toured before? Any new touring possibilities?
South Africa.
Yeah. Oh, cool.
First time going there.
Yeah.
Several Asian countries we've never been to, which is going to be amazing. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So you guys are just going to be on the road for a while now, right?
We always are. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Alyssa asks to ask Paulo if he has a girlfriend or not.
No, I'm single. Available
and ready to mingle.
What kind of ladies are your type? What kind of ladies should approach the merch booth for a little Paulo action?
I mean,
I couldn't think of anything funny that was appropriate.
You know, like anything unique, any kinds of styles,
whatever you
as
got.
Long as, yeah, you just gotta be.
Can have some tricks.
Yeah.
And don't be intimidated. Paulo's just a regular dude, ladies.
Regular
just
dude.
Don't put his right hand in your mind when you're thinking about.
Whoa, I don't know. Let's move on. What's happening with the Matt and Isan project? You said you were collaborating with Isan on something?
He's producing my side project, Mirtu. It's going to be a long time until we find any time we can do it, because with the Emperor reunion, with Trivium being on tour, who knows when that'll be. But we're both passing around ideas and passing the demos back and forth and constantly revamping little bits while we can.
And you got.
Yeah, he's really cool.
Finally got to meet him this last time we were in Europe.
And you guys are playing some summer festivals I saw next year. So you're
gonna be we're on the same days. I hope so. The one that looks like it may line up is Hellfest in France. I really hope we're on the same day. I really want to see them.
Oh, here's one from Matt Rhodes. What's going to make Vengeance Falls stand apart from previous albums?
I think the fact that when we look back at it now, when we listen to it in retrospect, we find that it contains the best ingredients of everything we've ever done across all five records. With Trivium, every record has been a little bit different from itself, and I think that's become a part of our sound, the fact that you never really know what exactly is going to happen on a record. And with Vengeance Falls, it has ingredients of first, second, third, fourth, and fifth records all in one. And it wasn't an intentional thing to do that. And the fact that I think all the legacy of what we've done is prevalent in a record, that's going to be a good thing for fantasy.
Cool. Well, guys, thank you so much for hanging out with me for a few minutes. I know you guys have a busy schedule. Check out Trivium on the road. You guys are going to be pretty much on the road all winter with Devil Driver and After the Burial.
Leg after we finish up. Pretty much taking us till around Christmas time. So,
Road Warriors, you guys. Yeah. And pick up their new album, Vengeance Falls, October 15th. And ladies, see Paulo on the road. I found the strike won't make the